Yo, what's going on, back on board crew? We're here at Greenville Tech, and it's a chilly day today. We're going to do some exploring on the Firestorm. We're just going to take it out. We're just going to have a good, fun time and enjoy the day. All right, back on board. Yo! Yo, what's going on, back on board crew? I had to take a little short 5-minute break to warm my thumbs up because it is freezing cold out here. And I just realized, you know, this is probably actually the highest that it's ever been with me paddling upstream here. It's like 5-1 something today. I think 5-1-1 or something like that. It really doesn't matter, but it's a good level and I'm really enjoying it. But enough of me talking, let's get back to it. Back on board. You. Yo, all right, back on board crew. I know y'all aren't gonna be able to see it, and I'm trying to watch out because I'm in this freaking tree right here. But there is the thing that I came up here for. It's a rapid call whirly bird, 360 whirly bird or something like that. I ran it like 5-6 years ago, and I've been wanting to look at it again. But me and this tree are between it, and I don't like crossing trees in the river by myself, especially stand-up board or canoe. So I'm gonna call it. It was a lot of work to get here because I had to walk up 2 rapids. I'm gonna try to run one because one's got a little bit of water in it. It's not even a rapid, it's just a shoal. But enough of me talking. Let's have some fun going back on board. Yep. Yo, what's going on, back on board crew? So at the last minute I decided all those shoals were a go, and I'm kind of glad I did because they weren't really bad. I didn't even really hit rock like I thought I would. This board has so much volume. I love the Firestorm. It just floats over most stuff that, like, on a lower volume board, like what I usually like to paddle, something slicey that you just banging on rocks, this thing just floats over it like a tank, doesn't even touch the rocks. Back on board. Yo, what's going on, back on board crew? Had to get the camera back out because we're at one of my favorite little spots on this section. It's a little rock formation, And I don't know, I just think it looks super cool, and I always like to film it, and when I go by it, and I always like to stop, but I never really talk about it. So I'm talking about it this time. It's just a little cool section and houses everywhere. Back when we first ran this, there was no houses that visibly that you would see on this run, but now it's just crazy, they're everywhere. But enough of me talking, time to get back to paddling, back on board. Yep. Yo, all right, back on board crew. So we rolled back up here at Greenville Tech, and it warmed up just a little bit. So I think we're gonna float on. I think we're gonna do some floating. Show y'all the other side of float life. Back on board. Yep. Oh, one more thing. That tree is still in that rapid way down there. So when the water gets low enough, we need to take this creek over here, take that creek, go around, and get a look at it to see if we can actually go beside it. Because it almost looks like you can go on the right-hand side. But at any level that would be runnable, I wouldn't attempt it unless I knew for sure you could get beside it, especially on a stand-up board. Because I like a really clean line on a stand-up, and you don't want to end up under or up on top of that tree. Because you would end up under it in a canoe. On a stand-up board, you could probably just jump off and get on top of the tree, but that's stupid, unnecessary risk that's not worth taking. Back on board. Let's get back to the vehicle. Yep. All right, what's going on back on board crew? So there's a lot of people here, but we still gonna float around for a little bit so I can show y'all the electric stoke back on board. Yep. All right, what's going on back on board crew? So I actually wanted y'all to see the river here. So this place is about 10-15 minutes away from the other spot we were at, and it has a park and play as well. But this place also has trails, so we come out here to rip the other side of float life, the electric shred. My buddy let me borrow that board, and I'm super addicted to it. I'm getting one of these things. They're super awesome. Enough of me talking, let's get back shredding, back on board. Yep. All right, what's going on back on board crew? I hope y'all enjoyed this one this week, and I hope y'all enjoyed seeing the other side of the float life. Hopefully we can do a little bit more videos like that coming up soon once I get my new board. And I go on ahead. Oh yeah, and I also wanted to mention this. Sorry the video kind of ended abruptly like how it did with the GoPro footage or whatever, but I was having some issues with my SD card, and that was that. But I go on ahead and hit y'all with this one, and we see y'all on the next one. Ships don't sink because of the water around them. Ships sink because the water around them gets inside of them. What I mean by that is, don't let what's going on around you get inside you and weigh you down. Back on board. Yep.